Our first responders and local emergency response officials and members of the Michigan National Guard and the Michigan State Police have been working through the night to help people get to shelter. I had a chance to talk with a few people downstairs who are sheltering here. I want to thank the city manager, the police chief, the local EOC, and of course, the lieutenant from the state police who is here with me, who's overseeing a lot of our state emergency operations center. I want to thank all of these people for their hard work and the incredible volunteers who have brought food and supplies to help their fellow residents. So to Midland residents looking for shelter, you can find it at Midland High School, Bullock Creek High School, and West Midland Family Center. If you're looking for information, do not call 911 unless that is your only option and it's truly an emergency. The most up-to-date information can be found at Midland911.org. Go online, or you can go to their Facebook page, facebook.com/Midland County Emergency Management. To get the most up-to-date information where you can get help and what the latest developments are. We are anticipating the height being around 8 o'clock tonight, and so we do know that the water is continuing to rise, albeit at a slower pace, but that's why we've got to continue to take this seriously. If you are in an impacted area and have not done so yet, please get somewhere safe. Follow the direction of our public health officials on the ground. I'm going to continue working with General Paul Rogers of the National Guard, Colonel Joe Gasper with the Michigan State Police, the DNR, and the Department of Energy, Great Lakes, and the Environment to ensure that we can keep Midland County families safe. I want to thank Jen Boyer, who is overseeing the local emergency operations center. They've got an incredible operation that has come together. So I've been in touch with local leaders in Midland and will stay in close contact with them as this situation develops. I want to continue to remind people, if you're in an impacted area, please evacuate. This is going to be hard, but we are anticipating several feet of water across this area. And so while we're in the midst of a global pandemic, it's really important that to the best of our ability, we observe the best practices to keep ourselves and our families safe. We're going to get through this. It is a tough time to be sure, but we are going to get through this. We know that tough times don't last, but tough people do. We have seen a community come together, and we're going to continue to do that until we get through this crisis. Stay informed and stay safe. With that, I'm happy to open it up for a few questions. Yes.
Governor, what's your reaction to the federal government? They knew this was an issue. They revoked licenses. There wasn't much oversight.
Well, I will say this, that regarding the dams, the state of Michigan is reviewing every potential legal recourse that we have, because this incredible damage requires that we hold people responsible, and we are pursuing and going to pursue every line of legal recourse that we can.
Should there have been more warning to the public that these were an issue?
Well, I think we're all trying to understand all of the different proceedings that had taken place up until this point. The initial readout is that this was a known problem for a while, and that's why it's important that we do our due diligence and then we take our action. That's
narrative.
At this juncture, there have been no reports of casualties, which is a pretty amazing thing, and it speaks to how seriously the people of this community took this, how many times flooding has been an issue and people know what to do. It also speaks to the local emergency operations center and the local leadership, and we are working arm in arm to make sure that we continue to keep people safe. If that changes, we'll share that information as it becomes available. But at this juncture, we're very pleased to see a 10,000 person evacuation that has, I think, gone as well as something like this can go. And so it's a tribute to the local leadership, and we want to acknowledge that, and to all the people of this great community doing their part. Yes.
Governor, the president has threatened to pull funding from the state of Michigan and Nevada over the absentee ballot question. Can you give us a sense of your thinking about his hostility to the idea of mail-in voting, of absentee ballot, and the idea that he would take money given to the state for the COVID crisis away?
I'll just say this. You know, for 10 weeks, we have been in the midst of battling COVID-19. people of this great state have done their part, and we have seen our numbers flatten. We're not out of the woods yet, but it's taken a lot of sacrifice, and it has not been easy. On top of this 100-year event, we have a 500-year event in a flood that has absolutely devastated a lot of families, a lot of community, you know, a lot of parts of this community. To see Twitter this morning and to see rhetoric like that is disheartening, because I think it first shows you that there maybe was a lack of understanding of what the Secretary of State was doing. She said we're going to mail applications, not mail ballots, mail applications. And I would appreciate any federal partnership that wants to stay focused on solving problems and not get into politics. We got to take politics out of this crisis moment. And remember, we're all Americans. We are all fighting for our lives here and for our economy. And we all got to get this right and remember that one another is not the enemy. The enemy is a virus. And in this case, the enemy is also a flood. And we've all got to pitch in and get this right on behalf of the people that we're fortunate enough to represent.